we see the effect of total reflection. In that we see that a prism, mirage are looming, diamond, then stands into, isn't it? Then that we have one of important five-mark questions, you know, expression for the radius of the stands into, isn't it? In which, what is critical angle? The angle of incidence at which the reflector ray graces towards the boundary. What is that? The angle of incidence at which the reflector ray graces towards the boundary is called as a critical angle, isn't it? Then, what is total reflection? The light will be reflected back towards, what is that? The light will be reflected back towards when the angle of incidence will be greater than the critical angle. The light will be reflected back towards the same medium itself. It's called as a total internal reflection, isn't it? Then we see what's the condition for total reflection. The light must be traveled from denser medium to darker medium. The angle of incidence must be greater than, what is that? The angle of incidence must be greater than the critical angle, isn't it? Then the effect of total reflections, we see about that diamond, mirage are looming, the shaky due to the different layers of the shaky effect which forms the wet condition on the surface, the star is in mirage, isn't it? It refers to the cold region, they form an inverted image, that's called as a looming, isn't it? Then we see the sense window. What is sense window? When the light will be far from outside and it can be outside from the water and observe a view from inside the water, the view can be restricted by a particular angle which is equal to the critical angle. The restricted area is called as a Snell's window, isn't it? The restricted area is called as a Snell's window. From that we learn the radius r is equal to d by root of n minus n square minus 1, isn't it? D by root of n square minus 1. Then today's sessions we are going to see about the optical fiber. So optical fiber, what is optical fiber? Optical fiber is a tool which is used to, what is that? The optical fiber is a tool which is used to transmitting the signal in the form of light, isn't it? So optical fiber is a tool which is used to transmitting the signal, is carrying the information in the form of light. So here the transmission is possible. What is that? They are transmitting the signal in the optical fiber. What is that? They are transmitting signal in the optical fiber is possible due to the phenomena of total internal reflection. Okay? Due to the phenomena of total internal reflection. So the optical fibers works on the principle of, what is that? The optical fibers works on the principle of total internal reflection. Okay? So we know that optical fiber is a tool which carries the information or signal in the form of light. So here the transmitting signal through the optical fiber is possible is due to the phenomena of total internal reflection. Okay, in which the inner part of a fiber is called as, what is that? The inner part of a fiber is called as a core. The inner part of a fiber is called as a core. The outer part of a fiber is called as a lining. The inner part of a fiber is optical fiber is called as a core, and the outer part of a optical fiber is called as a lining. The refractive index of a core is, what is that? The refractive index of a core is always greater than cladding. The refractive index of a core is always greater than cladding. So, the light is in the form of, what is that? The signal. Whatever signal, okay? The signal is in the form of light, incident at a particular angle. What is that? Incident at the core cladding surface. The light signal is in the form of light, incident on the core cladding surface at the angle of incidence should be greater than the critical angle. The angle of incidence should be greater than the critical angle. So the total reflection takes place, so the light will be transmitted without any losses. The light will be transmitted, the fiber will be transmitted the signal without any appreciable loss. Okay? So what's the point? The information, what is that? The information is the form of light, which will be incident at the core cladding surface, the angle of incidence should be greater than the critical angle. So the total reflection should be take place. So the light will be transmitting through the optical fiber without any appreciable losses. Okay? Without any appreciable losses. So while bending the optical fiber, I switch that in such a way, the total reflection, what is that? The total reflection will be ensured that while bending the optical fiber, we should be assumed that by such a way that to ensure that the total internal reflection ensured for every reflection. Okay, the total reflection will be ensured for every reflection. Okay, so what are the point here? He says that what is optical fiber? Optical fiber is a tool. What is that? Optical fiber is a tool which is carrying information in the form of light. Here, the transmitting the signal in the optical fiber is possible due to the phenomena of total internal reflections. We can simply say that the optical fiber works on the principle of total internal reflections. The inner part of optical fiber is called as a core, the outer part is called as a cladding. The refractive index of a core will be always greater than what is your refractive index of a core will be always greater than cladding. So the light, the signal in the form of light, which will be incident on the core cladding interface at the angle, and the angle of incidence will be greater than the critical angle. And the angle of incidence will be greater than the critical angle. So the internal reflections will be take place. While the bending of a fiber, you should assure that the total internal reflection ensure the reflection of ensure the reflection at the every point of incidence. Okay? Every point of incidence. Clear? Then we are going to see the acceptance angle in the optical fiber. What is the acceptance angle? Okay, what is the acceptance angle in the optical fiber? Acceptance angle, okay. What is the to ensure the critical angle at the core cladding interface? To ensure that and critical angle at the core cladding interface, the light should be incident at the light should be incident at a particular angle. What is that? The light should be incident at a particular angle. That angle is called as an acceptance angle, and this acceptance angle is depends upon the refractive index of a core cladding and the outer medium. Core cladding and the outer medium. So the light should be incident at a particular angle. That angle will be considered as an acceptance angle. Okay. So it form a refraction RA at the point of A. Then at the point of core cladding surface, it incident at the angle of critical angle. It will be incident at the critical angle. So the refractor will be raised towards the boundary. The refractor ray will be raised towards the boundary. Okay. So what is acceptance angle? To ensure the critical angle at the core cladding interface, the light should be incident at a particular angle at the core. What is that? The light should be incident at a particular angle at the core. The angle is called as an acceptance angle. The angle is called as an acceptance angle. So here the point of A and point of B, incidence and the reflection will be happen. In your book, it will be represented by I, it will be represented by R. Okay. Here I will be represented by IA minus RE. IA minus RE. Okay. Clear. So, by Snell's law, what is that? By Snell's law at junction A. Snell's law at junction A. So, incidence will be represented by IA, reflections will be represented by RE. So, what do you get? Refractive medium will be N3, while core, the refractive index will be N1. Is like, we know the Snell's law formula. What's the formula? N1 into sin IC is equal to N2 into sin R, isn't it? N1 into sin I is equal to N2 into sin R. Here, the refractive index of a medium R will be N3 and the core will be N1. So, write N3 into sin IA is equal to N1 into sin RA. Okay, sin RA. That will be equation number 1. That will be equation number 1. Then, Snell's law at point B. For a point B, the angle of incidence will be IC and the refraction is equal to 90 degrees. And the refraction is equal to 90 degrees. So, right. N1 into sin IC is equal to N2 into sin 90 degree. Okay, sin 90 degree. From that you can say that sin IC is equal to N2 by N1 because sin 90 degree is equal to 1. Sin 90 degree is equal to 1. tau from the triangle B A C. From the triangle B A C. Okay, from the triangle B A C, the angle of incidence IC is equal to 90 degree minus RD. From the triangle of BAC, what is that? From the triangle of BAC, the angle of incidence IC is equal to 90 degree minus RD. So if you substitute this, what you get? The sine 90 degree minus RA is equal to cos RA. Sine 90 degree minus RA is equal to cos RA. So if you substitute this expression, what is that? If you substitute this expression, the equation number 2 means, what do you get? The cos RA is equal to N2 by N1. Cos RA is equal to N2 by N1. Here, we know the trigonometric formula, is it? What's the formula we know? Sin square RA plus cos square RA. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. From this, sin square RA is equal to 1 minus cos square RA. From this, sin RA is equal to root of 1 minus cos per RA, isn't it? Sin RA is equal to root of 1 minus cos per RA, isn't it? So from the trigonometric formula, what is that? From the trigonometric formula, what is that? From the trigonometric formula, sin square theta plus cos per theta is equal to 1. So sin square RA is equal to 1 minus cos per RA. So sin RA is equal to root of 1 minus cos per RA. So if you substitute this expression here, means sin RA is equal to root of 1 minus cos square RA. So what's the LF cos RA we find? N2 by N1. So if you substitute this, what we get? The sin RA is equal to root of 1 minus N2 square by N1 square. N2 square by N1 square. So if you take a cross multiplication, is what we get? The sin RA is equal to root of N1 square minus N2 square by N1 square. Okay, clear? Now, from the equation number 1, what is that? From equation number 1, what's the value of sin RA? From equation number 1, the value of sin RA is equal to N3 by N1 into sin IA. N3 by N1 into sin IA. IA means acceptance angle, okay? So if you substitute this in previous expression, is what we get? The N3 by N1 into sin IA is equal to. Okay, here root of N1 square minus N2 square by, from a root if you take outside, means what we get? The N1. So square term will be cancelled. So from this expression, N1 N1 will be cancelled. From this, N3 into sin IA is equal to root of N1 square minus N2 square. N1 square minus N2 square. From this expression, sin IA is equal to what? From this expression, sin IA is equal to what? From this expression, sin IA is equal to what you get? The root of N1 square minus N2 square by N3. Okay? Maybe if you want this, you can take it as a root, okay? So if you take it as a root, this what you get? Sin IA is equal to root of N1 square minus N2 square by N3 square. Okay? For a medium of air, isn't it? This is a medium of air, isn't it? So from this, we can take as N3 is equal to 1. N3 is equal to 1. Okay, if you take a medium of air, N3 will be 1, means what we get up? Sin IA is equal to root of N1 square minus N2 square. From this, IA is equal to sin inverse of N1 square minus N2 square. Okay, root of N1 square minus N2 square. So the angle, what is that? When a ray of light will be incident from an angle, what is that? When a ray of light will be incident from an angle 0 to IA, which form a cone. Which form a cone, what is that? Normal at the end of optical fiber, normal at the end of optical fiber, forming a cone is called as an acceptance cone. The forming cone is called as an acceptance cone. Okay? Clear? So what is my acceptance cone? When a ray of light will be incident at the incident from angle of 0 to IA at the normal to the coordinate surface, or normal at the point of incidence, which forming a cone is called as an acceptance cone. Which forming a cone is called as an acceptance cone. And the numerical aperture is equal to what is the expression N3 into sin IA is equal to what is the expression N3 into sin IA is equal to numerical aperture. Then what is the expression N3 into sin IA is equal to numerical aperture. From this, so if you substitute means the numerical aperture is equal to root of N1 square minus N2 square. The numerical aperture is equal to root of N1 square minus N2 square. Okay, clear? Clear. Okay. So what's the point of? So if a ray will be, what is on? If a ray of light will be, or if when a light will be incident on a coordinate interface, the light should be incident particular angle on a core. What is on? The light should be incident a particular angle at the core. The angle is called as an acceptance angle. The acceptance angle is depend upon the refractive index of a core, N cladding, and the outer surface median N3. Okay, from this, the sensor at the point of A, what we get? N3 into sin IA is equal to N1 into sin RA. That will be equation number 1. Then for a point of B, at the critical angle IC, the incidence will be 90 degrees. So what we get? N1 into sin IC is equal to N2 into sin IA. Here, compare it. N1, N3 and N1. Because first one is the median N3, second one is at the core. So median will be N1. And here, N1 into sin IC is equal to N2 into sin 90 degree. From the sin IC is equal to N2 by N1. N2 by N1. Okay. Now, from the triangle of BAC, IC is equal to 90 degree minus RA. So, sin 90 degree minus RA is equal to cos RA. So, we substitute the expression cos RA is equal to N2 by N1. From that, we know that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. From that, sin RA is equal to root of 1 minus cos square RA. So n2 square minus n1 square, we take LCM n1 square minus n2 square by n1 square. Then from the equation number 1, the expression for sin RA is equal to n3 by n1 into sin A. Okay, so we substitute the n3 by n1 into sin A is equal to n1 square root of n1 square minus n2 square by, from when we take out root of n1, so n1 and n1 will be LCM. So n3 sin A is equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square, sin A is equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square by n3. From this, sin A is equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square by n3 square. For a medium of here, n3 is equal to 1, so sin A is equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square, IA is equal to sin inverse of root of n1 square minus n2 square, which represents the acceptance cone. Because when the ray of light will be incident the angle of 0 to IA, IA, at the normal to the incidence which forming a cone is called as an acceptance cone. And the expression n3 into sin A which gives the numerical aperture. So the value of the expression for the numerical aperture is equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square. Clear? Clear? So I hope you understand this question. The next one is the refraction in a glass. What is the refraction in consider a glass rail. What is the? Consider a glass rail having a thickness G in which two refractions will be taken. At a point here, this will be a rarer medium and this will be denser medium, isn't it? So when a light will be moving from rarer medium to denser medium, it move away from, move towards the normal, but at the same time the light move from denser medium to rare medium, it move away from the normal. So here the refraction will be taking place at the 2 point. Okay, at one place when the light will be moving from the anode to denser medium, it move towards normal, and other place at the point when the light will be moving from denser medium to anode medium, it move away from normal. Okay. So in this, so the light will be moving towards the point. Point B. So this will be normal. Okay. So when the light will be instead of point, the move towards horizon, it move towards an horizon. So the light ray will be move towards the refractor ray will be move towards the normal. Okay. At the point of A. And here, one more. Okay, so when a ray of light, what is that? When a ray of light instant the point of heat, what is that? When a ray of light will be instant the point of glass plate or glass layer with thickness of T. So we know that when a light will be moving from rather to denser, it moves towards normal. So the refractor light will be moved towards the normal. Okay, so the refractor light will be moved towards the normal. This will be angle of incidence, this will be angle of refraction. At a point of B, what is that? At a point of B, okay, what happened here? The light will be moving out from denser medium to rarer medium, isn't it? So what happened here? What happened here? The refractions will be move away from the normal, isn't it? The refractions will be move away from the normal. Okay, clear? So we just get only 2 points, considering this glass lab having the thickness T. When the ray of light will be instead the point of A, from narrow medium to denser medium, the refractor rays are moving towards the normal. So this will be N. Okay. Then the refractor ray move towards and reach the point of B. At here, it moves from denser medium to narrow medium. So it deviated away from the normal. So the ray come out from a glass slab having a same that they both are having a parallel, the instant ray both will be, the refractive ray and instant ray are parallel each other. Okay, in which the direction of both instant ray and the refractive rays are same, but the path of an instant and refractive ray will be different. So this will be a instant ray, this will be a refractive ray, both the ray are parallel to each other. So the direction of instant ray and the refractive ray will be same. And they are producing a lateral displacement L. They are having a lateral displacement L. But the path of what is that? The path of an incident and refractor ray will be differ by the lateral displacement L. Okay. So what's the point here? We say that considering a glass cup having a thickness T, when a light will be found on a glass plate, 2 refracting will be happen. When it is found from rarer to denser medium, the refractor ray will move towards the normal. And when it is moving from denser to rarer medium, the refractive ray will move away from the normal. So the refractive ray will be parallel to the incident ray. Okay. So the direction of the incident ray and refractive ray will be same, but the path taken by the incident and refractive ray will be differ by the lateral displacement here. From that we run the point C is done perpendicular to the point. Okay, the point C is done perpendicular to the point. And this will be considered as F. Okay, and the difference will be G. Okay, clear? First, from the triangle of ABC. ABC. Look at it. ABC. So when the angle of deviation of the land is there, when the ray of light will be moving from rarer medium to denser medium, the angle of deviation B is equal to I minus R. So here we take as I minus R. Okay, I minus R. From this, the value of sine I minus R is equal to, what's the sine I minus R? Opposite side by, say that, opposite side by, say that one, opposite side by hypotenuse, isn't it? So this is the angle, opposite side, hypotenuse, adjacent side, hypotenuse, isn't it? So the angle of sine IC is equal to, what is that? The expression for sine IC is equal to BC by AB. BC by AB. In which the expression for BC is equal to L. Right? BC is equal to L. From this, AB is equal to what we get the BC by sin I minus R, which is equal to L by sin I minus R. This will be equation number 1. This will be equation number 1. From the second triangle ABF, from this the value of cos R is equal to, from this ABF, the value of cos R is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. So adjacent side AF by, what is that? AF by, what is that? AF by AB. Okay. So the value of AF is equal to T. So cos R is equal to T by AB, because T is equal to AF. Okay. From this AB is equal to T by cos R. Okay. So by comparing the expression 1 and 2. By comparing the expression 1 and 2, what we get the T by cos R is equal to L by sin I minus R. So we are going to find the lateral displacement, isn't it? We are going to find the lateral displacement from this. L is equal to T into sin I minus R by cos. L is equal to T into sin I minus R by cos R. Okay. So the lateral displacement will be directly proportional to the thickness of a glass slab. What is the lateral displacement will be directly proportional to the thickness of a glass slab. When the thickness of a glass slab will be increases, the lateral displacement also increases. Corresponding to the greater the angle of incidence, when the greater the angle of incidence, the lateral displacement also increases. Greater, okay? When the angle of incidence will be greater, the lateral displacement also increases. So from the triangle of ABC, we find sine I minus R is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. So what we get? BC by AB. From this BC is equal to AB. AB is equal to BC by sine IR. So AB by sine I minus R. Okay. Then from the second triangle ABF, we find value of cos R, AF by AB. AF is equal to D. From this cos R is equal to D by AB. Okay. From this AB is equal to D by cos R. We putting the both down. T by cos R is equal to L by sine I minus R. From this lateral displacement, L is equal to T into sine I by R minus cos R. So the lateral displacement is directly proportional to the thickness of the glass slab, and this is also when the angle of incidence will be greater, the lateral displacement also increases. Okay. Clear? So for this session, we see about the optical fiber, in which the derived expression for the acceptance angle and numerical aperture. The next one is one of our important fiber question. Derived expression for refraction in glass slab. Okay, clear? So you should be learn this 2 fiber questions. Okay, time waits.